Hey, this is PCox. Welcome back to round three of a standard daily here on Channel Fireball. Yeah, we kept our opener. One drop, two drop with a pump spell, and hopefully a turn three of Johnny's. Pretty good. Kind of unfortunate this isn't a white land to guarantee that any land will make me cast a Johnny, but, it's three stomping grounds is the only thing that will not. Well, I guess the four green-white temples would slow me down, but would eventually let me cast it. So maybe playing against black-white devotion again. Player Dryad, or one drop that we can actually rampage if we need to. So we'll see if we get Thought Seized here. Not that that would be really that terrible. I mean, that would take a voice, which kind of sucks, but. Nothing. That's pretty good. And we drew a way to cast a Johnny. Everything's coming up PCox. Alright. Go ahead and get in there for two. And I don't think I've actually cast a Johnny yet in these videos. If I remember correctly. So, hopefully this game will actually see what the card does and why I like it. So if you watch any other white weenie videos, there's been a lot of Johnnies. Well, take our Gore Clan, but there are worse fates. So that would have actually been obviously pretty good here. Brimaz. Alright. Well, we'll just let him trade off if he wants to. Not a lot of reason to play a Johnny right here, aside from that he knows about it, but like it doesn't actually stop either of my guys from trading off, so not super exciting. Like if this was a Fleecemane Lion, I'd probably a Johnny in plus here. And you can't really do it with Brimaz, but one neat trick with a Johnny and Precinct Captain is like even if it's not gonna be like lethal or anything, just like when they tap out, especially against these decks that are mono removal, it is nice to just go like turn three a Johnny, jump, and then like you're guaranteed to get two guys. Brimaz is when he attacks, not when he does damage, so doesn't work there exactly, but. I guess we probably want to pump voice, because we kind of want to incentivize him to kill voice. I think that makes sense. Like, better for me if he kills voice than if he kills Drive Militant. And that Celestine Charm was actually a pretty good draw, because one of their better cards against us is, the Desecration Demon, though Voice is also pretty good against Desecration Demon, but being able to remove that is nice. Also, he plays like a Gray Merchant here. It is reasonably good to be able to, like, trample over past it. Though depending on what he does, he could just be dead. Like, because we can pump with Celestine Charm to 5 and then jump. So we'll see. Like, if he taps out here, he's dead. Which is kind of why I like a Johnny more than Boros Charm. Because as you can see, I don't have enough mana to go Boros Charm plus that. Plus I got to do something with Johnny first. Where as Boros Charm is just kind of pretty narrow. Alright, well, you're dead. Very dead with the Gore Clan. Alright. Just attack for a casual 14. There we go. Yeah, and I mean, not that the game exactly worked out that way, but like it's not uncommon or impossible to just win on like turn four with going like, turn one guy, turn two guy, turn three, pump a guy with a Johnny, then turn four, like jump and Gore Clan. I mean, not saying that happens a lot of games, but I've probably played, I don't know, 12 matches with the deck, and I've done that a couple times, so. Guess we'll sideboard the same way. Still not sure if it's right, but.